Good morning, children. So we started in our biology with the first chapter, nutrition in plants. I just wanted to give you a recall of the last class before we go to today's topic. We saw about what is nutrition. We need nutrition to build, grow and provide energy. Similar way, plants also need nutrition. That is what your chapter tells, nutrition in plants. So the nutrition is obtained from the food we eat. There are two sources of food, plants and animals. So plants which prepare their own food are called as autotrophs, right? Auto means self, trophs means nourishment. The plants which do not prepare their own food are called as heterotrophs. Even animals and we human beings are also come under the category of heterotrophs because we depend on plants for our food, right? Then we discussed about photosynthesis, how plants prepare their own food. So in the process of photosynthesis, plants prepare carbon dioxide and in the leaves. So they make use of water, minerals, carbon dioxide, chlorophyll and sunlight as the materials to prepare carbohydrates. We saw this diagram, right? In presence of sunlight, carbon dioxide and in the leaves, they have a green pigment called chlorophyll which captures the sun's energy and helps in the process of preparing carbohydrates. The water and minerals from the soil is utilized and carbon dioxide from the air is taken in and oxygen is released out. We inhale this oxygen released out by the plants. So we saw that in the leaf the plants have a very small pores called stomata. That small stomata will be like this, surrounded by the cells. It is just an opening pore. It opens and closes. That allows the intake of carbon dioxide and give out of oxygen. Okay. The next thing is photosynthesis means preparation of food by using light. The equation which we saw was carbon dioxide plus water in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll will in return give us carbohydrates and oxygen. Right, my dear children? Then we saw about that all the leaves, irrespective of the color, they have chlorophyll in it. Algae, the Tamil meaning will be Pasam Pudichirichi, they tell, right? That is what? That appears to be in green in color because it has the pigment chlorophyll in it and hence it is an autotroph. So not only plants prepare carbohydrate, they also prepare nitrogen and proteins also. So how do they get nitrogen? They get nitrogen from the air and from the soil. So from this air, gaseous state, nitrogen is a component of air. So they absorb from it as well as from the soil. They observe it either in the form of fertilizers or from the nitrogen fixing bacterias. Okay, so this is how plants prepare their food. So today we are going to see the next mode of nutrition, that is your heterotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic means the plants which cannot prepare their own food and they depend on the other animals. For this, open your textbook and to the page number 5. Can you see the figure 1.5 in it? Pause the video and open the textbook and hold a pencil in your hand. If you look at the figure 1.5, it would give you an example of how the cascata plant looks like. Cascata is an example of heterotrophic plant. It means cascata is also a plant, but it cannot prepare its own food. Does it mean that cascata doesn't have chlorophyll in it? Yes. Cascata is a rare case of plant which does not have chlorophyll in it, and hence it cannot prepare its own food, and that is the reason it is classified under the category of heterotrophic nutrition. The cascata, there is an interesting story about it. This plant will not grow by its own. It lives on the another plant for its growth. If you see the image in that picture, I mean in the page 5, figure 1.5, you could see the yellow color tubular structures like twining your stems and branches of the tree. That is what the cascata. The tree is a different plant and cascata is a different plant. The cascata is seen to be grown on the tree. It's in its stem and branches. So, these kind of heterotrophic plants always find a place in other plants for its growth. They depend on the other plant for its growth. The plants on which they grow are called host and they are called as parasite. I repeat again. So, the plants which depend on other plants for their growth will be parasite. And the plants on which they grow will be host. Okay? The next thing is we are going to see about insectivorous plants. Example will be pitcher plant. Now, please look at in the same page number 5, figure 1.6. That is called as your pitcher plant. Pitcher means a bag-like structure. This is actually a plant which is green in color. Okay, if there is a green color means it has chlorophyll. And it does not depend on other plant also for its growth. It prepares its own food by another way. Let us see how it prepares its own food. In the image, if you see, the leaves of the plant are changed into a pitcher, into a bag-like structure. Okay, the apex of the leaf, apex means the top portion of the leaf, will be transformed into a lid, like your bottle with a cap. The leaf is changed into such a way that it has a pitcher, a bag-like structure, as well as with the lid. Lid means a cap-like structure. Okay, so this plant prepares its own food by eating insects. Whenever any insects comes near this plant, the insect will be trapped inside the pitcher, and inside the pitcher you will have some hair-like structures which produces digestive juices. As we saw in your chemistry, that digestive juices will help in the digestion. So the pitcher plant will trap the insects inside the pitcher and secrete the digestive juices and absorbs the nutrients from the insects. So, okay, these plants, though they are green in color, they prepare food by their own self and they do not depend on any host. Still, they eat the insects to absorb the nutrients. The reason is, if some plants are not getting the adequate amount of nutrients from the soil, they are transformed into a insectivorous plant. So, this chapter mainly deals with how the plant is obtaining nutrients in various mode. First, we saw about the autotrophic mode of nutrition. That is, the plants prepare their own food. Next, we saw about the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, in which the plant depend on other plants for their growth. And the third case was insectivorous plants. So, insectivorous plants means which will prepare its own food as well as will eat the insects for its growth. Okay. And the fourth case will be saprotrophic mode of nutrition, or saprotrophs. That means the plants which
depend on dead and decaying matter to absorb the nutrients. Saprotroph means which depends on dead and decaying matter. Example will be fungi. So have you seen the fungus formations anywhere? Now you do one thing. If you have a slice of bread, just eat one half of it and leave the remaining half on a table. Okay? Leave it as such for 2 days and go watch on the third day for the half slice of your bread. It would be affected by the fungus and you could see some small thread-like, cotton thread-like structures coming from the bread. That is the formation of fungi in the bread. So this fungi is actually used in a various way. It has both advantages as well as disadvantage. We are using the fungi in a useful manner. That is, we eat mushrooms and yeast. Yeast is used as an ingredient for the baking of cakes and bread. Okay? And the fungi may even cause diseases to animals and humans. It is used in medicines. Pickles, leather and clothes will get affected by fungus in the hot weather. Whereas your shoes and wheat, paddies and all in the field will be affected by fungi in case of rainy season. If you see here that fungi has both the advantages as well as disadvantages. And it is always present in all the seasons, no matter whether it is a rainy season or a summer. The fungi has no boundary for the seasons. It can form whenever it wishes to. Because fungi is present in the air. If in case of warm or cold conditions, the fungi present in the air will choose the article and it will start to germinate in that particular area. Okay? So this is what a fungi, we saw that this is a plant which depends or which grows on dead and decaying matter will be your saprotrophs. Your mushroom is a plant. We have seen this growing near your Ooty regions and all. Yes, daily we have seen this coming in packets and packets. So that mushroom is also grown just because of the fungi in a cold region. Understood? So again, nutrition from dead and decaying matter will be called as saprotropic nutrition or saprotrophs. Okay, children. So we saw 4 modes of nutrition: autotrophs, heterotrophs, insectivorous plants and saprotrophs. Okay, the remaining let us continue in the next class.